Hi, welcome everyone.
The topic of this video is to apply a regression model to the turbo engine dataset provided by NASA. We won't be doing any sorts of exploratory data analysis or feature selection in this video. Instead, we'll try to train a random forest algorithm for this regression task and evaluate its performance on the test data. In the first step, we'll import the necessary libraries such as NumPy, Matplotlib, Pandas, Seaborn, and for train and test fleet, machine learning model itself, random forest regression, and some matrices. Once the model is imported, next we'll see the dataset available. The dataset given by NASA's website is in .txt format, but I have converted it into a CSV format. Please see the previous video to see the whole process. Link to that video will be given in the description. Here, if we see the data frame available here, it has total 26 column, which contains cycle number, operational settings, and sensor measurement data. And finally, it has the target variable, which is the remaining useful life, which contains the remaining useful life. So this is how the given data looks like. This particular block of code gives information about how many run of video data of engines are available, because engine fails when remaining useful life will be zero. If we analyze this block of code, here it says data frame of RUL block equal to zero. That means this RUL block, whenever it will be zero, that will represent that component has completely degraded, and the cycle will be at that time, that will be the remaining useful life. Similarly, you can see here that if we use this code, it will give us the data frame, but only with the rows where remaining useful life is zero. That means for the first engine, it ran for 192 cycles, second ran for 287, third ran for 179, and so on. I hope that is clear. Train and test fleet. Here, we will divide the data frame into feature and target column, and then do a train test fleet, where we'll keep 20% of the data for testing of the model, and the rest 80% to train the model. Then a random forest regression model is trained using the training data we have previously splitted. Here, the hyperparameter of the random forest model are auto-initialized. Training block. Let's see how the model performs on the training data itself. If we do the prediction here using the trained data, the output will be Y pred, and if we plot that along with the actual curve, that is the Y train, we'll get something of this sort of curve. We can see that the prediction follows the actual RUL train very well. This is the prediction and this is the actual one. And the root mean square error for the train set is 23.2, which is not bad. Now comes the important part of evaluating model's performance on the test set, which was not used during training. We can see that it has a root mean square error of 48.92, which is very high from the test set error which we got, which was around 23. That is one thing. And if we see the plot of comparison between the predicted remaining useful life and actual remaining useful life, we can see there is a huge deviation, and the prediction is not at all accurate. This is a very typical case of overfitting of a machine learning model. So that brings me to the end of this video. Thank you for your time. See you in the next video.